Basically saying like that she felt bad and that like people were attacking James and whatever. And then James made another video. This is all like so ridiculous. Like, why do we care about this so much? But we all do. Millions of people do. Like, I'm sure you do. Or if you don't, you know people that do. Like, I'm going on a tangent off of this tangent, so I'm sorry. Seen a lot of people posting, like, if only people cared as much about the global warming or the environment as much as they care about James Charles, then, like, we can make some serious change, and I agree with that, but I am just as guilty of funneling my time and energy into learning about James and Tati and Jeffrey and whoever else especially if it's about a brand deal or a sponsorship. I just don't. I just left a bad taste in my mouth, and so I did unsubscribe from James, so I guess you could say I'm like siding with Dotty or whatever. But yeah, I mean, I think all the drama's over now. After Jeffrey made his video, like, I think it's all over. But I saw all those articles about celebrities that have unsubscribed to James. That's crazy. He's losing subscribers. Dotty's gaining subscribers. It's just YouTube drama, you know, it is what it is. She's from Columbus, and I am from Youngstown, Ohio. So they're like 3 hours away, but my best friend goes to Ohio State and has seen Nina perform like several times before she was on Drag Race, so it's kind of cool because he feels like connected to her because he's seen her perform. So it's just really cool that she's on Drag Race, and he actually has seen her. So love her. I was super sad to see her go, and honestly, from the very beginning, I felt like it would be Brooklyn and Nina at the end. I definitely think it's gonna be Brooklyn at the end. If Brooklyn Heights does not win Drag Race, I will be shocked, disappointed, upset, enraged, etc. And I think that she's by far the best. She has the best record so far through the season. I think she's won like three challenges, and she's only had to lip sync once, I think. But she lip synced against Evie. So I guess in the top, like, who's left? It's at this point Evie, Akira, Silky. I don't know. because she's so sweet and, like, innocent seeming. So far, I'm not gonna lie, I think most of the guys that they cast for The Bachelorette are, like, not that cute. And, like, yeah, obviously there's more to looks or whatever, but at the same time, it's like, this is TV. Just not my up